focus.
Yeah. Welcome back to my channel, guys. It's Ronnie BM Fat Rice, and sorry about the noise because I don't want to shoot at my room in my room right now, because if you are following me on Instagram, that you should do. I'll be updating on what I'm doing right now, and most of you have seen what I have done, and it's raining now. Perfect. So we are talking about food photography today, just the basic setup with one light, maybe a second light, just to reduce the shadows on the other side. So yeah, let's get into it. Let's get into the video now. I was hungry after watching the rain and sunset out. Anyway, so the gear that I was using the Canon EOS R and the R5 with the 35mm, 50mm and 85mm, all 1.8. And the lighting that I was using was the Godox LC500 and the VL200. The VL200 is always my key light right now. At that time, during the shoot, I was using it at like 100%, which is 2 diffusion layer. I started using it with the grid, but then I stopped using it because it was casting the shadow on the white plate. So I stopped doing that. So it was just 2 diffusion layers and that's it, at a 45 degree angle. And it was mainly backlit because I wanted to get some depth and shadows on the food that I was shooting. So yeah. And the next thing that I want to talk about is, it was just a simple shoot with just the food, nothing else, no like setting up or anything. So before we continue this video, I forgot to tell you guys, this shoot was for Donna Factory, and if you are in Kochi, this is the best, this is one of my favorite places to have food, and go check it out. I will link the Instagram page of Donna Factory in the description below, so go check them out and let's continue the video. I think they just wanted a few photos for the Instagram, also for their menu. It's mainly for their menu. So it was just the food, a close-up, a mid and a wide shot. So that's it. It's not that much creative. I didn't have that much work. So yeah. I will give you some tips how to edit your food photography, food photo shoots and all. Mainly you want to preserve all the colors in the food and decrease some blues in the background and from the whites. So if you are using white plates and black backgrounds or blacks, the black should be like literally black and the white should be white. So always be aware of your white balance and the cast in the black, so that you will get a neutral tone in that. And always brighten up your image so that all the food can be seen and no details are missing. So yeah, so I will post the before and after the editing and like the edited shots. So yeah, let's get into it.
We'll be right back.
If you guys like this video, please like, comment, share, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for future videos. I'll be making more content and also follow me on Instagram. And I'll be posting there, like behind the scenes, when I shoot it. And you will get to see those things earlier. And I only post in YouTube like after like 2-3 weeks or months. Like in this case, like I shot this shoot at February, I think. I don't remember, yeah, February. Yeah, I'm tired, I'm sleepy, it's night. Like, I wanted to do this video in the evening, but yeah, it got delayed, now it's night. Anyway, good night.